Voters approved a change in the Constitution this past Tuesday, allowing the expansion of casinos in New York. Authorizing up to 7 full game casinos, the idea is to promote job growth, increase school aid, and permit local governments to lower property taxes. Did voters truly understand what saying yes meant? Guest speaker on The Richard French Show states this is turning into a lesson on both political language and gubernatorial clad.
Surprisingly thin margin when voters are asked if they want non-Indian Vegas-style casino gambling in the Empire State. The actual ballot language will say the casinos bring the potential for job growth and lower taxes if approved. And when asked in just that language, the referendum far more popular.
Gaming already exists in the state with 5 Native American-owned casinos and 9 racetracks. Republican Senator John Bonisick reports this past Tuesday funds can now extend to its surrounding communities.
The state would receive 80% of the cut of potential casino revenues, with casino hosting communities and the surrounding counties splitting the remainder.
Senator Frank Padovan has other concerns for the state of New York.
Over 1 million people who are problem or addicted compulsive gamblers. The damage they do to themselves is significant. Larceny, incarceration, social services, business failure, all the way down the list. And among them, suicides.
The building of 4 casinos is said to start in Albany and surrounding Pennsylvania areas, spending close to $1 billion in construction. That opens up 10,000 upstate jobs, both permanent and construction, $282 million in education and property tax relief, and $192 million in aid to local governments.